Hello, everybody. My name is X Factor, and anything can happen in Battlefield 1, and you need to be prepared. Today, we're going to go over how to set up your loadout, quickly change it, selecting different weapons and gadgets so you're prepared for the right situation. Do you need to be a medic up in close quarters where you're healing and reviving teammates, or do you switch it up, play scout, and drop some enemies from afar with a bolt action? It all starts here from your deployment screen. You're able to quick switch any weapon or gadget or any of the four classes, or you can hit the button in the lower left here called Customize to give you more in-depth analytical information for your selection. There are four different primary weapons available for the Medic class in the Battlefield 1 open beta. Two variants of each type of weapon, if you take notice, on the left-hand side. Now, they do share a lot of similarities with their rate of fire, the ammunition, the damage drop-off, the bullet drop-off. There will be differences in their irons, optics, than actual mode of fire. Some of these are able to go full auto and not just semi. There won't need to be any guessing games because you can see all this information on the right hand side of the screen where it portrays the damage, accuracy, hip fire, control, rate of fire, fire modes. For instance, this one is semi-auto, full auto, a fully loaded weapon, what it's capable of holding, the total ammo count, most importantly, the damage drop-off and bullet drop-off. Obviously, you can see this has a pretty flat projectile as the dotted line indicates, but the damage drop-off really falls off around 30 or so meters. So this weapon is really meant for close quarters combat. Still not sure which weapon to choose, but you can actually compare them in the menu. We've selected the 1907, and on the right, all the 1907 information will be in white. We've hovered over the Mono Dragon. That will all be colored green, red, or in yellow. It has more damage, more accuracy, less hip fire, and control. The bullet drop model is identical. The damage drop-off is much less severe and better at longer range. Next up is your first gadget slot. As the medic, we have multiple things. We have the medical syringe, which revives friendly players, can kill enemy players. The medical crate, which when you drop it, is an area of effect heal for anybody in close vicinity. But if you're being shot at or suppressed, it will stop. Then, of course, you have the bandage pouch, which is a quick heal. You throw it on the ground, somebody runs over it, they're healing to 100% until they take enemy fire. Not close shots, but actually be hit. Then, of course, you have underbarrel attachments for your primary weapon. You have the frag, smoke, and HE. The second gadget slot is going to give you the same options as the first. You just cannot have duplicates, so I could not run two underbarrel weapon attachments such as frag and smoke. I have to choose one from that category. Or I could not run double medical crate. I could run big crate and, of course, the bandage pouch or syringe and medical crate. The only question you have to ask yourself when playing medic, do you need to revive and heal, or do you need to revive and do some additional damage from afar? Battlefield 1 gives you multiple options when it comes to your grenade slot. There's the traditional frag grenade, the gas grenade, which will damage anybody that does not have a gas mask on at the time, impact grenade, which blows up when it hits something, incendiary grenade, the mini grenade, which doesn't do as much damage, but you actually get more of them, the smoke grenade, and the light anti-tank grenade. If you're the assault class, you get heavy anti-tank grenades, but you can also equip a light anti-tank grenade in your grenade slot, which is my favorite because armor is everywhere. If you hit the treads of a tank with one of these, it's going to do big damage and possibly keep it from repairing, keeping it in a disabled state, allowing other people to pile on and finish the tank. Lastly, when it comes to melee selection, it's not just about how you take down an enemy and the animation. It's the damage you could put out going into that animation, the speed at which you do it, and of course the kill zone. But it doesn't stop there. Each weapon has special extra abilities, as indicated in the lower right of the melee selection card. Can you take out enemy barbed wire? Can you take out enemy mines or harass enemy tanks? That'll all be determined by which melee you select. And are you selecting the right melee for the right game mode or moment? So with that said, which melee do you think fits your personality or play style? As always, guys, thanks for watching, hanging out, and we'll see you soon.
We have taken objective apples. We have taken objective Duff. We have lost objective Charlie. We have lost objective Duff.
Thank you.
We have lost objective apples.
Bomba fırlatıyorum. Dikkat eyleyin.
We are losing objective. We have taken objective apples.
Bomba atıyorum. Dikkat eyleyin.
Thank you.
objective dark. We have taken objective Charlie. Objective dark. George. Halfway there, the enemy has the upper hand. lost Objective George. We have lost Objective Butter. We have taken Objective Duff. We have lost Objective Apples. We have taken Objective George. We are losing objective Duff. We have taken objective Charlie. We have taken objective Edward.
Thank you.
we...
Objective.
Losing objective dust.